Los Angeles, New York, London, Ooh La La Paris, and Winter Haven. The eyes of the entertainment world have turned their attention to a sleepy little burg in Central Florida as everyone who's anyone is at the Ugly Sweater Christmas Party.
I'm entertainment reporter Hollywood. I'm here on the red carpet as the glitz and glam of Tinseltown migrates east, where two young lads, Eric and Mike, cast aside the humdrum of a normal day in exchange for the beauty and pageantry that is known as the Ugly Sweater Christmas Party. Celebrities, politicians, sports heroes, and everyday Joe alike all clamor for a mere glimpse of the holiday heroes that many are beginning to call the Christmas Merry Makers. Fans from all over have been camping outside the historic Ritz Theater for days in hopes of seeing the cavalcade of stars attending tonight's gala. Extra security was brought on to ensure law and order as the excitement for tonight's gala show reaches a fever pitch.
Excuse me, do you have a permit to be doing any of this?
No. Don't you know who I am?
No.
I'm Hollywood, entertainment reporter.
I don't really care. You just can't be doing this.
We've been given exclusive backstage passes to tonight's show. Come on. The cast and crew are busily putting up the finishing touches, scurrying around like little elves in Santa's workshop. Oh, Eric! Mike!
Where the hell is my shrimp?
Who put coffee in my coffee?
What has a guy got to do to get some shrimp around here?
I don't care if the kid's sick, I don't sign autographs!
Necesito shrimpo pronto!
Bloody hell. I can't do this anymore. Prima donna, no talented assholes. How can this night get any worse? This night can't get any worse. I shouldn't have taken this craptastic job.
I'm good enough.
I'm smart enough.
And people supposedly like me.
Gosh darn it, they love me.
Yeah. I mean, after all, I have a t-shirt with my face on it.
Look
and
at
I
that.
Swear to God, I look like Grady Judd in this that's... maybe been stung by a bee.
Break a leg, boys.
It's gonna be fantastic.
We're T-minus 15 minutes from the show. Let's just get it over with.
Yeah, we gotta get this done.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, a message from your government.
Good evening. I'm Lakeland Mayor Bill Mutz, and I want to welcome you to the Ugly Sweater Christmas Party. Eric and Mike have been major staples in our community for a long time. They've entertained us for more than 13 years with great comedy. They have helped us through trying times in our community, and their philanthropic efforts are beyond compare. They have again and again proven to be a beacon of light in our changing world. And it's for this reason I'm proud to proclaim today, December 15th, as Eric and Mike Day in Lakeland, Florida.
Hey, hold on, Mayor. I'm Winter Haven Mayor Brad Dantzler. Eric and Mike have been members of our community for a long time here in Winter Haven. They've been entertaining citizens and helping our wonderful nonprofits all this time, long before Lakeland even noticed they were even there. So that's why I'm declaring today, December 15th, Eric and Mike Day here in Winter Haven.
That's cute, Mayor Danza.
It's Dantzler, Bill. Come on.
Oh, whatever. Who's the boss? The point here is their studios are right here in the Lakeland, and we're the economic center of Polk County.
I hate to interrupt you again, Mayor Putz.
It's Mayor Mutz.
Ooh, look at me. I've got an alliteration in my title. Ooh, economic center. So, yeah, you've got Publix headquarters. I'll give you that. Big deal. We've got Legoland. And you're called Lakeland, and here we are. We have the city of 100 Lakes and the chain of lakes.
Yeah, that was an oversight.
Well, the point is, Winter Haven is a true destination for tourists from all over the world. Lakeland's just a glorified truck stop right off of I-4.
Well, at least our streets run north and south, east and west, not not northeast, southwest, north, southeast, west, south, north, you know.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Speaking of roads, how's that road diet working for you? I promise you, here in Winter Haven, we will never have a road diet.
Guys, we love Eric and Mike here in Bartow, too. Yay!
Bartow, what are you doing here?
Yeah, don't you have a flower festival or something to go to?
Yeah, yeah, bye, Bartow. See you later. I'm going to hang out. Bye now.
Look, I think we can all agree we both run beautiful cities. And we're both here to support Eric and Mike. They're good guys who mean a whole lot to us in all of Polk County.
True that. They are good guys, and we're just here to have a good time tonight.
So let's end the bickering. It's the holidays. We can bring them out together.
Sounds good to me.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Eric and Mike.
Merry Christmas, everybody!
Hey, everybody! How you guys doing? Make some noise! Yes!
Excellent.
We are very excited to be here.
Good evening and welcome to the 2022 edition of the Ugly Sweater Christmas Party. What about this in a real theater? How about that? Oh, that's awesome.
How's the food? Is everybody enjoying the food? Nice.
Did everybody get salad? Yeah.
Oh, you did? Good.
If you didn't, you blame that man, because he took about four helpings before we opened the door.
I thought eating light would be good before the show, and now I'm regretting it.
Yeah, really. There's a lot of people that we want to thank. The Ritz Theater, if you would, a nice round of applause for Ritz Theater. Westbury Audio and Video, they're the folks that have put this together. We also have our sponsors we'd love to thank. They include the Low Payment Kings. Low Payment Kings,
where are the
you
Low
here?
Payment Kings
where
at?
Are you? Yeah. Make some noise, Low Payment Kings. Also, Tunes and Tents, you guys in the house. There we go. Robert Ben's Roofing. There's enough to choke a horse. Yeah, those folks here.
Give them all a big round of applause, everybody. Come
Mannix on. Mannix Pools and Grills, Somewhere Sports Bar.
Yeah.
International Market World, Link's Buffet, Williford Flooring, Teriyaki Madness. Also, the 1916 Irish Pub. They're the folks that did the food tonight.
1916 Irish Pub really rolled it out, huh? The food is fantastic. Yes, fantastic. We have an awesome show for you guys tonight.
Absolutely.
We've got a great evening planned. We're going to do the Ugly Sweater Contest, of course.
That's right. Top prize, $500.
That's right, for that.
For the Ugly Sweater. That's coming up.
Fantastic comedian Dean Napolitano is here. He can hear you. Make some noise for him, please.
If you would.
And at the end of the night, we're going to give away to one lucky winner $1,000. Yeah. That's right.
It's called bribery to get you all here.
That's right.
That's basically what it is.
We had to get you here somehow.
But while we're handing out the thanks, there are a couple other people that we need to thank. We need to thank the mayors of Lakeland and Winter Haven for doing that video.
Yes, that was pretty awesome.
I'm going to tell you a little behind the scenes with this. The day that we shot that, you would have thought that these guys were, well, they were basically ready for a boxing match.
Oh, man. It was like blood was going to be drawn. Yeah.
You should have seen that boxing match that was
getting
ready to go.
It was going to be a boxing match for sure.
And I can just see it right now as the lights would dim and the players would get ready.
Let's get ready to rumble!
And then you would hear, in this corner, from Lakeland, Florida, fighting Bill Mutz.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And in this corner, from Winter Haven, Denson, Brad Densler.
A Christmas present.
Oh, wow.
A human Christmas present. Yeah.
Come on right over
He's
here.
He's even got the twinkles, you see, on his fingers.
Look at
that's
that.
That's pretty awesome.
How sweet is that? That is so cool. Well, come on, step on up,
yeah,
gentlemen.
Step up here to the center, guys.
We're shy. We're both shy.
Yeah.
And thank you once again for being a part of this, both of you, very much. Give them another round of applause, please.
Yeah, thank you. It's fun to be here.
Yes, we're happy to be here. Happy to host.
Are these pills?
This is a gift for you. If you'd be paid, I'm going to give you a nice gift here in a minute.
Oh, you are?
I'll go ahead and do it now. You know, Winter Haven, people don't know this, but I'm a beekeeper. One of my hobbies is I'm a beekeeper.
Wow. That is a sting.
Yeah. And because Winter Haven is the sweetest city in Polk County, I brought you a jar. Read the label.
Mayor's Select, farmed locally in Winter Haven, Florida.
There you go. Right.
That's awesome.
That's because I love this guy, whether he loves me back or not. We still love Lakeland.
No, I got you.
We will not have a road diet, by the way.
Oh, they're great. They help you with pens. I got you. This is really special. This is special. A business card. There you go.
Thank you.
That's funny. Well, I think we're going to be honored tonight, and we really appreciate that.
Yes,
Mayor Dantzler.
We'll let you take it away, Mayor Dantzler.
We do have a proclamation officially voted unanimously by all our commission, and all 550 employees voted unanimously on this proclamation. So let me read it real quick. This is Winter Haven, the Chain of Lake City, a proclamation for Eric and Mike Day, December 15th, 2022. Whereas in the year of our Lord, 2010, the heavens saw fit to join together two incredible forces of talent known by their common earthly names as Eric and Mike.
Wow. That's pretty
And whereas since that time, Eric and Mike have used their talents to entertain the masses, be it by original comedy, groundbreaking benchmark hits and bits, or the simply through the enchanting and seductive sound of their angelic, honey-laced voices.
Well,
whereas,
how are you doing?
Over the course of the past 13
like yours,
years.
Brad.
Please, Mayor, it's my time in the sun, okay? If
okay.
you don't mind.
All right.
Go right ahead. No, go right ahead. Too many mayors up here.
You're going to like this.
All right.
Over the past 13 years, their philanthropic efforts have raised thousands of dollars for local charities and nonprofits, selfless volunteering hours upon hours of their precious and very valuable time for the betterment of our community. And whereas this day, December 15th, 2022, marks the third annual Ugly Sweater Contest, and we are proud to have chosen Winter Haven's historic Ritz Theater for this festivities. Now, therefore, I, Brad Dantzler, Mayor of the City of Winter Haven, do hereby claim December 15th, Eric and Mike Day in the City of Winter Haven.
Yeah!
Wow, awesome,
there
awesome.
You go. We have our own day!
There you go.
The show's over, I'm going home.
Yep. It's official.
Where did you get this frame? At a dollar store? I mean, seriously, dude.
We buy them by the case.
But they're special for you.
Thank you very much. Well, cherish that.
Yeah.
Well, we appreciate everything. We appreciate everything that you've done for us and with us. You guys have great sports. When we wrote the script for this, we didn't know whether you guys would accept it or not because you were taking some pretty healthy swipes, but we really appreciate everything.
Because we love each other.
Excellent.
Well, thank you guys once again for coming out and being a part of it.
We really appreciate it.
One more time,
thank
everybody,
you for being here.
Mayor Butts and Mayor Dantzler.
Max, 98.3.
Oh, my goodness.
We'll see you tomorrow morning, starting at 6.
Hey, don't forget to follow us on all the social medias and have a fantastic day. Audio.
Another flawless broadcast
in
the books.
In the books, baby.
That's right.
That's why we get paid the big bucks.
Oops. Hello? Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, we'll be right there. Thanks.
What's going on?
That was the boss. He wants to see us in the office.
Like the boss?
The boss.
Oh boy.
You're out, bro.
Guess what? We have a mystery.
Oh, ooh. Okay.
In my world, they call that a clue. Mm. Okay? It appears we have a thief amongst us.
Oh.
And it's not just any normal thief. You think it's him?
No, I didn't do anything.
I know you pointed at him.
No.
But we have copy paper that's missing. Did you hear?
Copy paper.
It ain't toilet paper. I understand toilet paper. But copy paper, someone's stealing it.
I hate copy paper.
It wasn't me, boss.
I don't even like that stuff.
I didn't take any
here. But you know what? You were talking about it on the air, on the radio. Oh, it's okay to take copy paper. Did you do that?
Okay. All right. Look.
I recognize the voice.
Yeah, that was him. I was talking about it as a bit on the air. I would never take anything from my work or you or anybody at all.
I'm just kidding. Y'all are the best radio personalities. Your ratings are up. It's the funniest thing I ever heard.
Oh, thank you so much.
Yeah, I mean, listen, I don't want to mess up the deal y'all got going, thank you very much, because the higher the ratings, the more money I make.
Oh, that's right. That's good. That's good. All right, Sheriff.
We'll see you later.
All right, take
care,
thanks,
brother. Good to see
you.
Y'all.
Thank you.
Oh, wait a minute. Do you have time for a crazy criminal story?
Sure.
Listen, I got crazy criminal story. Did I ever tell you about the crazy lady with the neck tattoos?
No.
She was doing naked cartwheels.
Yeah, we got
I got another story.
Oh.
I'm just kidding. Y'all can go.
All right. Thank you very much, Sheriff. We really appreciate you so much. Yeah. And we'll just see you next time.
What is that?
I forgot to tell you, I found that in the hallway.
Copy paper!
I found it in the hallway.
In the hallway.
Yeah. That's yours.
Wait a minute. So if when I dust this for fingerprints, it's only going to have my fingerprints?
Yes. Well, yes, pretty much. Thanks for everything,
Sheriff. Have a great day, Sheriff.
Have a great day, Sheriff.
Thank you so much.
Bad boys, bad boys. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, bad boys.
I want you to know that I'm completely innocent of anything. Ladies and gentlemen, do me a huge favor. Make some noise. Polk County Sheriff Grady Jones.
There it is.
How are y'all tonight? Hey, brother.
Hey, man. It's good to see you.
Good to see you.
Thanks for finally showing up. It's great.
It's nice to see you really working for a living.
Yeah, finally, for once. Finally, right? Yeah, exactly. But we wanted to welcome you and invite you here to the Ugly Sweater Christmas Party tonight.
Isn't this totally awesome? I appreciate y'all being here. Hey, these guys, I give them a real hard time because they ask me stupid questions on the radio sometimes. They are two of my favorite people, and it's so easy to interview with them. I have to be careful or we might, like, say something and get us in trouble.
I take that as the highest compliment because several times off the air, he has been so close to, or he has said to us, you got me to almost say something I wasn't supposed to, and I don't like that.
These guys are the best in the business. You know that. Are y'all having a good time tonight? Well, you know, I wanted to come here and wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a happy and a prosperous New Year's. And these guys let me show up. I mean, that's pretty awesome.
We're glad that you came, Sheriff. You got any crazy criminal stories?
Do you know, I do have...
27 minutes later.
Yeah.
Do you know, we had this guy who went into a convenience store on 27 North, and he bought him a $2, or got him a $2.19 drink. So he walked past the exit where you pay, right? And she said, sir, it's $2.19. He said, yeah, I got it. And he continued toward the front door. And she said, sir, you haven't paid for your soda. It's $2.19. He said, yeah, I got it. And he walked outside. So she followed him outside. And she said, sir, you didn't pay for your drink. That's stealing. It's $2.19. He said, yeah, I got it. And he got in his car. Well, he failed to recognize he was in Polk County. And the lady there knows we don't put up with that nonsense, so she got his tag number and she called the office. And we caught him on Highway 27. Now, we turned these red and blue lights on, and he pulled over to the side of the road, and being the very professional and nice people we are, we said, hello, sir, how are you doing this afternoon? He said, I'm doing very well. How are you? We said, we're doing just fine. Where did you get the soda? And he goes, oh, I got it back at the store. Did you pay for it? No, sir, I didn't pay for it. So here's the evidence in plain view, right? So he said, sir, we have a present for you for Thanksgiving, because like this was the weeks before Thanksgiving. You get to eat turkey at the county jail on Thanksgiving because, like, you're going to jail. He goes, whoa, wait a minute. You're not really going to arrest me for stealing this $2.19 drink. I mean, after all, it's $2.19. We said, sir, do you own the convenience store? And he said, no. And we said, well, sir, do you have the contract for the sodas in the convenience store? And he said, well, no. Then we said, you're going to jail. He said, I can't believe you're doing this. And we go, it's theft. So we were putting him in handcuffs and putting him in the back of the car. He said, what are you going to do with my car? And we go, oh, we're going to tow it too. So you think about this. For $2.19, this dude got to post him a bond at the county jail. Then he got to go bond his car out of storage. You know what I'm saying? And now he's got to go to court because he wouldn't pay $2.19, right?
Wow.
Happy Thanksgiving.
And from what I understand, they serve turkey on a loaf at the county jail.
Well, you see, people in the county jail all think turkeys are square. You know that? Because we cut the turkey off of a loaf. I tell people, you know, the food at the county jail is nutritious, not necessarily delicious. So there you go. It's all about having a good time, putting bad guys in jail, crimes at a 50-year low. I don't ever want to forget to say that.
Yep.
And we're all safe, and we feel safe so we can come out and party.
There you go. Everybody, give it up one more time Sheriff Grady Judd. Thank you so much, Sheriff.
God bless you. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, man, that was awesome.
You know, I feel very, very connected to Grady. I think that we have a really, really good connection.
Yes.
But I know he'd throw my ass in jail quicker than anything. Yeah, in a heartbeat.
In a heartbeat. That soda cost that dude like $500. Inflation is ridiculous right now.
Yeah. That's the truth. That's absolutely the truth. So what do you think so far at the start of the Ugly Sweater?
Are you having fun so far? Well, we're about to ramp things up.
That's right. Because we are now going to get our very first qualifier to win $1,000 in cash. One moment, please.
Let's explain what we're going to do first. I'm going to come running out into the audience, okay? I need couples. We need couples for this. We need any couples that are out there. We need how many? Three?
We need three couples.
We need three couples, okay? So you guys, if you want to come up here and play to qualify for the grand prize of $1,000, you better make a lot of noise.
That's right.
Who wants to play?
Who wants to play? Husband and wife. We can take boyfriend and girlfriend. We can take boyfriend and boyfriend. We don't care. Come on up. All right, we need, where's everybody?
They're making their way down. They're making their way down. They're making their way down. I got them. I got them.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, boy.
Excellent.
Right this way, guys. You're just going to come right up here in the center of the stage over here.
That's right. All right. Don't be shy. Come on.
Come on up.
We only have the theater rented till 9, so let's move, people. Let's go. There we go. Excellent.
All right. Two of you here in the center, and then the other two over here with me.
Excellent. All right. Great. So what we need now is for the men to take one step forward. Men, one step forward.
Men step forward. Men on this line.
Ladies, step behind the men.
Get behind the men.
Excellent. Let's start here. What's your name, sir?
David.
David, and you are with?
Amy.
And she is?
Behind me.
I understand that.
Wow.
Genius. Genius. Is she just somebody you found on the street and you invited to the party or what? Who is she?
She told me to put this on and come, so I showed up. No, she's my wife.
Oh, excellent. How long you been married?
4 years.
4 years?
Wow. She answered for him. Did you guys hear that?
Good God.
She had to answer for him.
The way you're going, it won't make 5.
Yeah,
okay.
You're kidding. Holy moly.
What's your name, sir?
Wayne.
And you're with?
Roslyn.
And she is what relation to you?
My wife.
Excellent.
There we go.
That's how you answer these questions there, Dave. And how long have you guys been married?
8.
8 years? Maybe 9. 8 happy. 9 total. Okay, great. And who you got
and
there?
And you are, sir. You are.
I'm Wally. My wife, Whitney.
I'm sorry, say that again.
Wally with my wife, Whitney.
Very nice. And how long have you guys been married?
20, many, me a lot more than that.
20. What's a 21? She had a corrective. Wow, that's pretty good. 21 years. Not
How about
bad.
That? That's awesome.
Okay, then you mean you guys should all know a lot about your wives, right?
Yeah. Excellent.
I mean, obviously, you don't know. Some of you don't even know how long you've been married. But,
right.
But I would think that they know enough. Like, you guys would know your wife's waistline, wouldn't you?
Well, if you were to notice, the game is called Desperate Measures. Now, what we're doing...
Go ahead, Adam.
What we're doing is we're handing you some streamers. And what you're going to do, if I could take this one... Gentlemen, what you're going to do is you are going to guess how...
Small,
yes. The circumference of your wife's waist. And you will...
Oh, yeah, it's happening.
By the way, this portion of the show is brought to you by the divorce attorneys of Michaels and Lee. Now, you will then measure out, you will then tear it off. We will then have your wife step forward, and we will see who is closest.
There you go. Now, we want you guys to take your time and really think about it. Not yet. Don't get into it just yet.
Well, he's studying it.
We're going to give you guys exactly 30 seconds. No, roll yours back up, sir.
So we'll give you
an on your mark, get set, go, and then I want you to take your time and really think about it.
Right.
Because we have a video that plays, and it's exactly 20 seconds long, so if you go too fast, then we look stupid.
This is what you're going to do. You're going to think about it. You're going to say, that's about right there. And then you will kick your wife, or in this case, my morning wife.
Hey, you almost did it.
Wow.
Wow,
look
really,
at that.
I'm really doggone close. Good. That was awesome. Yeah, that was cool.
That's a big boy right there.
That's a good boy. So we're going to have you then. We're going to see, and whoever comes closest will then move on to the $1,000 championship, all right?
And if there's a tie, we will come up with a tiebreaker.
Exactly.
Are you guys ready? Take your time. Come up with a good guess. On your count of three. One, two, three, go!
Now, think about it. You can act like you're hugging her, you know? You can just kind of close your eyes and imagine it. And,
There you go. You can just lay the roll on the ground there whenever you're done.
Yeah, that's it. You can just drop it down. That's fine. That's good.
No, all now, right. Hold on.
Two,
wait, we'll do
one,
it.
One, and we're done. All right,
okay,
go ahead.
We're
tear
done.
It off. Just tear,
right, rip yours
tear it off
where you like it.
Tear it off. There you go. Excellent. Thank you so much. All right. We'll start down here.
Yep.
Come on up. Come on up, baby doll. That's awesome. All right. Now, it's across the belly button. And why don't we have you turn profile. There we go, profile. Now, you will come in front of her, and let's see how close you are. Yeah, in front of her. There we go. Look at this.
Hold on.
Oh,
he's over by just a little bit. We got, like, maybe a marker here. Maybe a marker. We can mark it. Perfect.
You didn't realize you were getting an exam when you were here, yeah? All right, move your hand if you would.
Now, you know that whenever he goes over like that, it means he thought you were bigger.
All right. If you were to hold on to that, please. That's excellent. Okay, next up, please. Next up.
Here
That's
we go.
Cool. Stand profile. Go ahead and arms up.
Sucking it in.
There you go. That was good. Here's a quick little kiss just in case I never see you again.
Oh my goodness gracious, look at that.
Oh.
He's like, turn around and show them. He's like almost dead on.
Woo.
Wow. Okay.
Oh, that's good.
All right.
Let's see how
you did here.
You can keep that as a souvenir if you want to.
All right, go ahead whenever you're ready. Let's see where you're at. Oh, boy. Oh, he's short by about 2.5-3 inches.
Oh,
you can turn that way. Oh, I think we have a pretty clear winner.
That means couple number
right
two.
Here in the middle. Way to Excellent. Go, guys. You are the first qualifier for the grand prize game of $1,000. You guys can all head back to your seat. Give
You're
them
right.
a, another Thank round of applause, please, as they make her way back down.
Thank you. Central Florida. Always known as the Mecca of vacation destinations, but it's also known as the home of the magical Big Mac's morning show with Eric and Mike. We know them as a supernova among the stars. But surely, we aren't the only ones who feel this way. That's why we took our cameras around the world to find out what people think of Eric and Mike. Let's start at their workplace. This is where lucky people get to interact daily with these entertainment superheroes. You there, what do you think of Eric and Mike?
What do I think of these guys? I think they're hardworking, dedicated employees, and all-around great guys.
How about you, happy coworker?
F them.
Excuse me, what are your thoughts of Eric and Mike?
Eric and Mike? Who's that?
And you?
What do I think about Eric and Mike? Do they still work here?
Here's a busy IT professional. Say, what do you think of Eric and Mike?
Eric and Mike? I'm cleaning their browser history right now.
Eric and Mike's appeal is far-reaching. People all over the community recognize their name. You, busy executive, what do you think of Eric and Mike?
What do I think of Eric and Mike? Well, they're the human form of gas cramps.
And you, everyday barber?
Eric and Mike, their show is the reason the middle finger was invented.
How about you, sir?
Eric and Mike, you know, every time I see those guys, the first thing I think is clean up on aisle three.
Don't just take our word for it. Eric and Mike's charm and talent is known worldwide.
Eric and Mike, I'll tell you what I think of them. They're a right pair of proper plonkers.
Cheerio, mate! Bonjour!
Bonjour et bienvenue à Paris. Eric et Mike, on vous attend à la guillotine.
Oui, oui! It's unanimous! The Big Mac's morning show with Eric and Mike, a true beacon in the entertainment world!
Wow.
They made that video for us. I just love that.
Yeah, it's fantastic.
It was so heartwarming.
Oh, man. One more time for Eric and Mike, I guess. That's yeah. That's what that video was all about.
No, we're supposed to do the sponsors again because they love to hear themselves.
They do. We have to do the sponsors again.
Yeah. Hey, sponsors are here. How about that? Give it up for them.
RBR, Manix Pools and Grills, Somewhere Sports Bar, right. 1916 Irish Pub, the Ritz Theater, Tom Westbury and the Westbury Audio Group.
Keep going. I'm impressed.
Go ahead. I'm listening. Have I missed anybody? Oh, yeah. The Low Payment Kings are in the house. We love the Low Payment Kings.
Tunes and Tent and Robert Ben's Rooming.
There we go.
International Market World, Link's Buffet, Williford Flooring, Teriyaki
nice.
Madness.
We love all of you guys. Thank you so much for helping us put this on.
I know what will get them more excited.
I know exactly what it will.
It's time to get another qualifier for the $1,000.
Yeah.
This time, guess what? We're looking for couples.
Hey, that's weird. All right, I'm going to come out of there. I need couples. You got to make some noise. I'm looking for excited people. Excited people.
Who wants to play?
Who wants to play? Come on.
I love the fact you're just sitting there with your arms crossed.
No, no, don't call on me. No.
That's awesome. Oh, come on. Okay, you're in. Oh, wow. He's all the way at the top. There he is. I'm glad you're waving at me because I'm not the one picking anybody. It's all Mike doing all this. All right. Have we got him? We got our people? Excellent. Come on down and join us here on the stage.
Yeah. No, you guys are coming. Come on, come on, come on, come on.
No, you don't go that way, sweetheart. You come to the front of the stage like everybody else.
Yeah, go right to the front over here.
Wow.
Oh, boy.
I guess, come on up.
She was super excited. Him not so much. Yeah,
come on up. Join us. Hello. Hello, come on up. Come on. Come on, old people. Let's go. Let's go. Chop, chop.
Now I know why she was so excited. Look, they didn't even think to put their cocktails down.
No,
they just brought them up here. Party, who's drinking tonight? Where are the drinkers at? Ah!
All right. There we go. This is going to be fun. Good gravy.
This is what happens when you expect the audience to do your show for you, Eric.
That's true. Yeah. Here we go. Okay. All right. This game is called Wrap It Up. What's going to happen is you're going to be given wrapping paper. One of you has to wrap the other one with wrapping paper. You can discuss the strategy if you want. Now, the rules are you have to use all of the wrapping paper. You have to use the bow. There is no tape. There is no scissors. There's no cutting. There's no tearing. You have to use all of it. You have only 60 seconds to do this. You will be judged on neatness.
Don't start unraveling yet. We're not quite there,
why
sir.
Why cheat, sir? So you'll be ruled on neatness. You'll be ruled on completion of wrapping. You will be judged on various other things that we'll make up as we go along. All right?
That sounds good.
All right. So
all right, you have 60 seconds. You got to use both full things of wrapping paper, and the bow has to be incorporated somehow. All right?
All right.
Now, you can wrap the legs individually. You know, if you do that, you're really good. You can wrap the arms individually. You could just mummify them if you want. I mean, however you want to do it.
Right.
But you got to use it all. Yes. All right. Are you guys ready?
Are you ready? Are any questions? Clear as mud. We're good to go. Yeah. Okay. Yes. The restrooms, they're out front. Yes.
All right. Are you good?
No.
Yes.
No, you have to go back to the table wrapped up.
With the wrapping paper on. Yeah.
That's excellent.
All right. Are you guys ready to see this? All right, here we go. On your mark, get set, go!
Go!
You've got 60 seconds, and you got to use it all.
This is even better than I imagined. Don't forget the bow. All right. All right, audience. You're going to help us count down. Here we go.
Oh, my gosh. Holy moly.
Help us count it down. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And we're done.
There we go. Holy moly. All right.
Woo, doggy.
Here's what. All right. I'm thinking we'll start right here. By round of applause, how many of you think that this should win? Make some noise. Okay. All right.
How
about over there?
How about couple number one right here?
That's pretty good.
Wow. That's good. That's good.
And what about right here, couple number three?
Ooh, I think we're pretty close. Let's do one and three one more time. Couple number one, make some noise.
Wow. All right, and one more time for couple number three. I think it's one.
I think it's couple number one.
I know. I think it's number one.
Congratulations.
Give it up for number one, everybody.
All right.
Oh, my gosh.
You guys are now qualified to enter the championship, the grand prize of $1,000. If you would, one more time for all of our contestants.
One more time as they make their way back to their seats. Holy moly. Oh, don't worry. We got people to do this. There we go.
How about it for our stagehands that are here tonight? Nice round of applause for them. Excellent. Our little elves helping us. All right. How many people have cable TV? Excellent.
There's still people out there that have cable TV?
I guess so.
I'm shocked.
Yeah, I'm one of them.
I'm actually shocked.
There is a channel called the Bravo Channel. And, we have the Bravo fan here. That's great. Good to see you. And on the Bravo Channel, they had a television show called Inside the Actor's Studio. Now,
we know some of you know it. That's good.
Cool. Inside the Actor's Studio was shot at the New York Performing Arts, the University of Performance Arts, or someplace that Mike and I never went to.
NYU or something like that.
And what they would do is they would bring actors on stage, and they would be in-depthly interviewed about their craft, about their history, about their background, about what they did to get into certain roles. And it was in front of master's students and doctoral students, and it was a very highbrow show where they had a lot of well-known actors on it.
Well, we thought we would do something similar.
Well, we always do a Q&A every year where the audience asks questions. And we're like, this year we're going to have so many people, we wouldn't be able to get to that. So we'll just have somebody come and do this and do an Inside the Actor Studio. But we couldn't get James Lipton. I don't know. He wouldn't return our phone calls.
It had something to do with him being dead recently.
Yeah, apparently
what? Is it too soon? Are you related to him? Come on.
I don't understand. You reincarnate for us. Do you know who we are?
Yeah, nothing. Yeah, well, not it's like happen. Our career, like that joke.
Yeah.
But so what we did is we scoured the local Starbucks, and we finally found a gentleman that looked like he knew about movies because he was writing a screenplay on a MacBook.
There you go, exactly.
So we present to you tonight Inside the Max Studio.
There.
Or something else.
There. Close the BGM song. Hit X on the BGM song. There you go.
Yeah, what the hell?
There he is.
Good evening. Radio. Is it America's national art form or antiquated anarchy over the airwaves? I thought I would ask two of radio's biggest stars to answer that question, but Howard Stern wouldn't be caught dead here, and Casey Kasem was caught dead. So I brought two of my nearest and dearest acquaintances, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Eric Lee and Mike Michaels.
Thank you. Thank you, yes, thank you.
For this first question, I will ask you to summon your years and years. And for Eric, years and 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 years of broadcast experience. Hamburger Helper, America's national cuisine or a culinary catastrophe? I want you to think about all of your broadcast experience and answer this question.
Hamburger Helper is... We have it every morning for breakfast almost at the station. It's a culinary masterpiece.
Thank you.
Yeah.
What was the radio show that inspired you both to go into radio?
Anybody from Chicago?
Yeah, all right.
Larry Lujack, WLS. Who's with me on that one? Anybody? One person. Great. That's awesome. Larry Lujack, in my opinion, is the greatest jock that ever lived and ever will live. YouTube him sometime if you would. He was a master of the silence. He would be able to tell a joke and just pause long enough for you to laugh at home as if you were a part of it. My favorite joke that he told was he was reading a PSA, and I hand to God, this is absolutely the truth, and this is like 1978, 79, when you did not say anything like this on the air. He's reading a PSA, and he says, Girl Scout Troop number 142 will be at the local Montgomery Wards wrapping holiday packages. Yes, you too could have a Girl Scout wrap your package. And it was masterful silence, and then he, AM89, WLS, and then hits the bridge of the song. And I just thought that man was a god, and he was the one that got me into it.
Well, that was a way better story than I have. And I also very highly doubt that there's anybody from Oklahoma City in the crowd. Exactly. We don't get out much. But I used to listen to a duo named Jack and Ron on 98.9. They're still on the air today together in Oklahoma City. And they did all kinds of wacky, crazy characters, like what you think of old school radio, where they were playing, you know, Richard Simmons. Somebody would voice it. You know what I mean? Always impersonations and things, which is probably why we like playing Name That Tomb, where we can play where I'm very good friends with Igor. That's a Disney reference. So, yeah, that was mine. It was Jack and Ron.
Well, thank you for those introspective insights. I think I speak for everyone here when I say those are precious moments that we'll never get back. Thank you. And now for a more serious question. If one Muppet were to successfully seduce you, who would it be and why?
Peppy the Prawn because it would look so big.
I was going to say. Just,
our CEO is here.
I was going to say Miss Piggy because I've always wanted to pork her.
Tune in tomorrow when it's nobody on the air.
By the way, this is our farewell show.
Exactly. What a delight. If you had fulfilled your childhood dream, what profession would you have right now? I'm doing it.
I'm also doing it, but not exactly how I thought I would be doing it. I went to school for theater and production and everything else, so I always wanted to be an entertainer. So here I am. I'm entertaining, hopefully. Yeah, thank you.
Hey, I didn't know your mom was here.
Thanks, Mom.
Not a therapist in the land could help. If your superiors at Hall Communications were to describe your program in one word, why would it be disappointed?
We didn't know these questions before, and just he did not vet them. He didn't do anything. He just said, I'm doing my thing. You guys answer as best as you can. And I'd like to say F you.
Oh, my God. That was brilliant, by the way. That was brilliant. What is it you love most about what you do? Good parking spots in the afternoon after I get off the air. Okay, I've always wanted to do this since I was in seventh grade, and it comes so naturally to get up and entertain and to make people laugh and to have fun and enjoy things and not take life too seriously, because Lord knows there's enough serious stuff out there. We don't need to do it 24/7. I mean, are you with me on that one?
Yeah, no kidding.
And so I really love this bonding experience. This group of minions is the most rabid group of fans I have ever seen in my
life.
How
many minions we got in the crowd tonight? Who's officially, yeah? Love
it's,
the minions.
It's amazing, and we truly are touched by you guys every single time. That group, that Max Minion group, is simply amazing. Anyway, I love what I do because it's an awesome job.
Yeah.
Emphasis job.
No, I love doing it as well. I didn't know how much I would love doing it until I started doing radio, and then I was just like, oh my God, this is what I was meant. I should have been doing this the whole time. I just love it. I love going on and talking to the people and making people laugh and seeing you out and about, and you know, you come up and say, hey, I heard this joke that you did on the air, and I died. I almost, you know, wrecked my car on the side of I-4, and I'm like, oh, that's what it's for. Because whenever you're on the air, it's not like here where you tell a joke and people laugh. On the air, you're just going, well, I hope that was funny. I have no idea. Eric chuckled, but I could tell that was fake. He was faking it. So, you know, it's nice. It's nice to see the people out, and it's just nice to entertain and be a part of something that is so fantastic. So,
you two have such a way with words. It's like watching Michelangelo paint the Sistine Chapel with Crayola crayons. I think Abraham Lincoln had a better night at the theater than this. Oh, too soon?
Wow, he's only on page 2.
It's an extensive interview. I prepared months. Gentlemen, when in the throes of ecstasy and the vigorous physical love exertion, what is your favorite thing to exclaim?
My favorite thing to exclaim is, oh, Billy.
I just simply say, big hits. Wow, that went over like a lead balloon. That was great. That was awesome. And
Yes. And you're both divorced, correct?
Yes.
Yeah.
What personal vendetta do the both of you carry against a balanced, nutritious diet and light and moderate exercise?
It's been a long struggle. It ruined me when I was a kid.
Yeah. Oh, God, I can't.
Breathe. When you tie your shoes. The final question, and I've been assured by the management of Hall Communications, you would answer this question, or you'd get a pink slip in your stocking from Santa Claus. What is one thing that you have never told anyone that you would like to say right now, and you must answer the question?
Want to go first there, Mike?
One thing, deep, dark secret.
One thing that I've never told anyone, and I have to answer this question right now. I shave my butt sometimes.
What a delight.
Mine is a confession. No, I don't shave his butt. For the past 6 years, this has really eaten away at me. It has really, really bothered me. Being 1,000% serious here, that this is the one thing that we have done on the air that has hurt me the most. And it was the fact that I made the declaration that if the Chicago Cubs won the World Series, that I would get a tattoo. And unfortunately, all of you have remembered that. And you all continuously remind me of it. So I'm here to tell you, in July, I got a tattoo.
You did?
Yes, I did.
You did? You son of a bitch! What? You're kidding me.
If you are a Max Minion, you can now go on the Max Minion page because it just went up. Pictures of me getting my tattoo, which is of a Lego man in a Chicago Cubs uniform.
Unbelievable. How did you keep that secret this whole time? I honestly had no idea.
What gets me is that we have been in the studio, and I'll do a lot of... or scratch or something like that, and the sleeve will come up real quick, and I'm like, oh, crap, I gotta hide that from Mike. Nobody at the station knows.
Well, they do now. They the do boss now. Is sitting right there.
But I remember when I went on vacation?
Yeah.
And I went on that cruise on Virgin Cruise Line, and I kept saying, they've got a tattoo parlor.
Yeah.
How you doing?
Really? Damn it. Now I feel like the only pussy who doesn't have a tattoo.
That's what the championship round is Mike gets one. So there you go. My confession, and honestly, yes, if you go onto the Minions page, you can see pictures of it.
Wow.
The India...
Fantastic.
The India Ink Company made a fortune. To finish this, I'd like to quote my grandfather the day he turned 97. Dear God, can we please finish this? Eric and Mike, you are to radio as what Kim Kardashian is to radio. And I want to say to finish that, to sum up my feelings, I thought about doing this evening, and it was just almost as if I had died and gone to the pearly gates, and there stood St. Peter, and he said to me, not too soon. And I said, oh, am I going to the other place? And he said, no. That's too good for you. You're going to cover the Eric and Mike Ugly Christmas Sweater Party, Max 98.3. And I've had a blast, and it has been a delight. Good evening.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Christopher Rode. Give him a round of applause, everybody. Thank you. Holy moly.
It is time to get our last qualifier.
Is that right?
Yeah.
We don't bring...
No.
Okay.
Nope.
How you doing? Oh, no, no.
Calm down. You don't even know what we're doing yet. We are going to need six volunteers, individuals, six individuals. So if you are ready to play, make some noise.
All right, I need six people, six individuals. One right there, you. How you doing? All right, go for it. You go up there too. Hold on a second. I want to come up here. Who are we going to get? Hold on. You want to go? You go
six
up there.
Six people.
You go. I'll do you, yeah. All right, I need one more person. One more.
We
all the way
six.
Over there, we
Who
haven't got anybody
play?
Yet. Hold on. Go on down to the stage,
come on,
guys.
This way.
I chose
come
you.
Come on. Come on up.
All right, we'll take you. Go ahead.
You're in the center of the stage. Come on up. There you go. Perfect. Excellent. On this line right here, if you would, please. Stand right here on this line. Ladies, step forward on the line, please. Excellent. Who's our last one? We got our last contestant right there. Excellent. Very good. Michael, this is for you.
Okay, thank you.
All right. What we're going to do right now is we're going to do a joke-off. But it's a different type of joke-off. Have you ever watched online the bad dad jokes? Well, that's what we're going to do tonight.
Can you guys scoot a little bit closer? Go ahead. No, no, no. I'm sorry. Not step forward, but like
closer
literally
together.
Closer together.
Closer together.
Towards the center here. There we
yeah,
go.
Yeah, there you go. Speaking of English, eh? Closer. There we go. All right, cool. Now, what you contestants have to do is you have to stare straight forward.
Look yeah. straight forward at
straight
the audience.
Straight forward. Hands down to your side.
Find a spot somewhere in the back.
That's right. All right. And then you cannot smirk. You cannot wink. You cannot do anything. As we tell you bad dad jokes.
Last person standing wins.
That's right. Mike and I are the judges as to whether you smirk or laugh. Like number two there with the
yeah,
elf.
She's already
like,
lost.
She's already
she's
lost.
She's out.
Yeah, there we go. Excellent.
All right.
Well, then we'll find out real quick. Hi, what's your name?
Jerry.
Jerry? Yeah. What do you do for a living, Jerry?
Going to school right now and be a teacher.
Great.
Nice. Well, good.
Good luck with that. What's your name?
Jarrett.
Jarrett and Jerry.
Wow.
All right, excellent. What do you do, sir?
I drive trucks.
Excellent. That's what we love. Loads of truck drivers.
Truck drivers.
What's your name?
Cindy.
Everybody, Cindy. Cindy, everybody. What do you do?
I'm semi-retired.
Oh, excellent. I am every day from 6 to 10. And your name?
Carrie.
Carrie? Hi. What do you do for a living?
Occupational therapy for special needs kids.
Oh, excellent. How about that, huh?
Gesundheit.
And you are?
Cheyenne.
Cheyenne, everybody, if you would. This is Cheyenne. And what do you do?
I'm a stripper.
Awesome. Cool. No. Oh, you're kidding?
I'm a cleaner.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, I guess you
stripper,
could.
Cleaner, same
yeah,
thing.
Yeah, same thing. Yeah, really. And your name?
Tori.
Tori. And what do you do?
I'm in high school.
Really?
How old are you, Tori? How old?
17.
17. I'm sorry to do this to you, Tori. Can she win? Oh, no. I think you have to be 18.
Yeah, you have to be 18 or
I'm
older.
I'm so sorry.
But wait.
Oh, wait.
Hang
hold
on.
Hang
on.
On. Hang on.
Hang on. Give me the basket.
I am so
Give
sorry,
basket.
Tori. I didn't know that
Give
you were
me the
under
basket.
18.
Here we go.
Look at that. We're going to give you something. We're going to give
Here.
You.
Here. This is just for coming up. This is compliments of the low payment kings.
There you go. Tori, so sorry. All right, we need one more. I want somebody from the back there, because that's the only place I haven't gotten from. Hold on.
In the back. I can't hear you. What? All right, do we have our sixth person?
Yes, we do.
Excellent. I love the fact I'm getting people up here going, is that tattoo real? Yes. And it was real painful. When I went and got it done, originally it was supposed to be yay high. And the guy says, I can't give you all the detail. I need to make it larger so it goes as large as it is. We went from an hour to 5 hours doing this thing.
I cannot believe that. It's awesome, man.
Thank
I can't
you.
Believe you held it. You kept it from me. I feel betrayed.
You feel cheated on? Okay, wow. That's all right.
Okay, what's your name?
Cindy.
Cindy, what do you do?
I work from home.
She works from home.
Excellent. Ooh,
fancy.
All right. All right, players, get into the zone.
Here we go. You know the rules, right, Cindy? You got to look straight forward. You're not allowed to laugh. No smirking, nothing. Deadpan face as we give our jokes.
Now, you need to laugh. You need to groan. You need to cheer. You need to do whatever.
Try to get them distracted.
Try to help them get distracted.
All right.
Are we ready?
I think so. I'll start with a softball.
All right.
Why did Mrs. Claus cheat on Santa? He was never present.
Jerry, you're very close.
Jerry?
Very close. I'm going to let you slide on that one. Keep your eyes open and look forward. All right, you ready? Here's number two. Why did the chicken cross the road? Just because?
It's tough. This is tough right now. Why should you never punch a mall Santa? I don't know. Security wouldn't tell me.
Oh, all right.
Wow.
What did Michael Jackson call his denim store?
What?
Billy Jeans. Wow. In rehearsal, they were already knocked out by some of these things.
Oh, man. What do you call an elf wearing earmuffs? Call him what you want to. He ain't coming. Yeah! That's it. You're gone. I'm sorry. I saw her about to break.
We're down to five.
We're down to five. Here we go.
This is an oldie but a goodie. How much does a roof cost?
How much?
Nothing. It's on the house. Mm-hmm. All right.
All right. What do you call an old snowman? Water. Are you listening to me? That was funny, damn it.
What do you call a milkman in high heels? A dairy queen.
Why is Frosty the Snowman like my father? He said he would be back one day.
Did you hear about the man who dipped his stuff in glitter? It's pretty nuts. Did you get it? It's pretty nuts. Pretty nuts. Pretty nuts. Pretty nuts.
Oh, man. Woo. It's getting tough, man. What did the snowman die of? Frostate cancer. Frostate cancer. Frostate? Okay, fine. I'll go home.
This is one of my favorites. Why did the toilet paper not cross the road?
Why?
It got stuck in the crack.
Oh, gosh.
You see? Stuck in the crack. You see? Crack, toilet paper.
You know
paper.
What I'm saying? Toilet paper. Crack. Are you getting close to laughing?
Yeah. Garrett is, I can tell. Doggy.
Are you guys meditating? Is that what you're doing? Are you trying to meditate? No smirking.
Your turn.
All right. What happens if you get a cold at Christmas time? You go on the snotty list. The snotty list. Get it?
I am going to call Garrett. He smirked on that one.
He did?
I'm going to call Garrett on that
one. Yeah, we got it.
I'm going to call you on that one, buddy.
Garrett.
We're going to call you on that one.
You're out on that one, buddy. You smirked.
Nice job. We're down to four.
We're down to four, and I've only got like two jokes left. Okay, I'm just kidding. I've got more. Let's do this.
Here we go.
Yeah.
What do you get when you cross 50 female pigs and 50 male deers? $100,000. Get it? $100,000.
Anybody?
Nothing. Anybody?
Okay.
Okay.
Ah, jeez.
We thought this bit would be over quickly.
Yeah. All right, this one's got to get them. You know, all I said was things would be a lot different if Santa were gay. And now everybody thinks I'm ho-ho homophobic. Ho-ho homophobic. It's a gay joke. Anybody?
Is this the trance you go into when you're stripping? Just curious. Okay.
You guys are stoic.
Yeah. What did the sock say to the pants? Sup, britches? Here, I'll do it so you can see it. Sup, britches? Yeah, no, yeah, all right.
I see the corner of that mouth rising. All right, here we go. How do you make an elf horny? Fairy moans. But pheromones.
It's great when you explain it.
Yep. It makes it so much better. Anybody? All right, fine.
What did the guy say after he burned his Hawaiian pizza? I should have turned the heat a little lower.
Wow. That was really bad.
Lower.
Uh-huh. Hey, have you guys heard about the elf that they're calling the new king of rock and roll? Elvish Presley? Elvish Presley? I don't think they're listening to us anymore.
What kind of underwear do clouds wear? Thunder pants? Thunder pants.
All right. What's the difference between Cardi B and an elf? An elf can rap. Wow. Unbelievable. How do we do a tiebreaker on this? I'm sweating here.
Yeah. I've got a few more.
Okay. All right, go ahead.
What do you call a sketchy neighborhood in Italy? The spaghetto. You're remembering these, and you're going to tell them tomorrow, aren't you? Yeah, you are. Yeah, I can tell.
I'm going to have to start just going to some old ones that I remember. This is now, I've used them all. Why does a mermaid wear seashells? Because she grew out of her bee shells.
What do you call a man without a nose or body? Nobody knows. Nobody knows. Nobody knows.
My dog ate an entire bag of Scrabble pieces. I had to take him to the vet. No word yet.
No word yet.
Get it?
What did the zero say to the eight? Nice belt. See, zero, eight.
There was a belt.
See, zero is big and round like me. And then you put a belt on, and then it just...
And it makes an eight.
It makes an eight, you see.
You see?
Big and round. Works. Like me, big and round.
Hey, did you guys hear the one about the curb? It's all over town. Did you hear the one about the fence? I can't get over it. Did you hear the one about the rope? I'll skip it.
You're getting worried, aren't you?
Yeah. You want to just make them do a thumb war?
Nope. Did I tell you that my cross-eyed girlfriend just broke up with me? She was seeing somebody on the side. Wow.
They're in a meditative state.
I guess. Note to the producers, we're not doing this next year. What does a house wear? A dress. Yeah, a house wears an address. A dress. Okay. Let's see. What did the horse say after it tripped? Close. Help, I've fallen and I can't giddy up. Wow. And then Mike leaves me. This is great. Okay.
No, I literally had to go get my phone. I've got a million of these stupid jokes, but I can't seem to remember any of them right now.
I'll do another one here.
Okay, go ahead.
Why should you never buy a woman a watch?
Why?
Because there's a clock on the stove.
Wow.
Hey, did you get that, Jerry? No? Didn't get that? Clock on the stove? No? Okay.
Oh, man. I am I'm at a loss here, Eric. All right, give me your...
A man went to the zoo, and there was only one animal. It was a dog. It was a shih tzu. You see the play on words there, Jerry. Shih tzu is a dog. Can also be used as an adjective.
I'm afraid for my Christmas advent calendar, its days are numbered.
Okay. Why do the cows have hooves instead of feet? Because they're lactose intolerant. That was good. I don't care who you are. Lactose intolerance, good.
You know, singing in the shower is fun until you get soap in your mouth. Then it's just a soap opera.
What did the janitor say when he jumped out of the closet? Supplies! Wow!
I believe that's supposed to be, what did the Asian janitor say when he jumped out of the closet?
Holy cow.
Anything? I'm in pain over here. Dear math, grow up and solve your own problems.
Is that it?
Yeah. Oh. Have you heard about the chocolate record player? It sounds pretty sweet.
Okay. Hey, we don't go to your work and tell you how to hand out carts. So we'll go ahead and do this, all right? What's orange and sounds like a parrot? Carrot. Get it? Parrot, carrot. It's orange. Sounds like a parrot. Carrot. Nothing. Wow. What's this? Keep going?
A skeleton walks into a bar and says, "Hey, bartender, I'll have a beer and a mop." Do you get it? Because he's a skeleton. And when he drinks, it just, yeah, okay. All right, I think it's time to start drawing numbers.
I'm not done yet. I worked hard on these. I've got five more. My girlfriend asked if I had seen the dog bowl. I said, no, I never knew he did. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. What do you call a chick with a piece of lettuce in his eye? in his eye. Chick, you know, as in a bird. Oh, there we go. It's a chicken Caesar salad. Caesar salad. Okay. What does the zombie vegetarian eat? Grains.
I'm calling in backup. Chris, come out here.
A guy's drunk at a bar. He throws up on his shirt and says, "Oh, great, my wife's gonna kill me." Another guy says, "Don't worry about it. Do what I do. Put 10 bucks in your front pocket. Tell your wife someone else threw up on your shirt, and they give you that money to get it dry clean." He says, "Great," and has 20 more beers. He goes home blasted. He wakes up the wife, "Hey, honey, I'm home." And she looks at him and says, "What a disgrace. You got vomit all over your shirt." He goes, "Don't worry about it. Another guy threw up on my shirt. He gave me this money to have it dry clean. It's 10 bucks. He gave me 10 bucks to have it dry clean." She goes, "That's a $20 bill. He goes, "Yeah, he crapped my pants too."
Why couldn't the bicycle stand up on its own? It was too tired. Too tired bicycle. You get what I'm saying, don't you, Jerry? Okay, that's true. Keep your eyes forward.
A three-legged dog walks into a bar and says, "I'm looking for the man who shot my paw." What do you call a deer with no legs? I don't know. What do you call a deer with no eyes? No idea. What do you call a deer with no eyes and no legs? Still no idea. What do you call a dog with no legs? Call him what you want to. He ain't coming. You could give him a cigarette and take him for a drag. What'd the mama buffalo say to the baby buffalo on the first day of school? "Bye, son." Wow.
I think we go to a tiebreaker.
I think we're going to have to. Really, like, amazing job, you guys.
Yes.
But we were not expecting that to happen. So what I've done is I have written down on here, I've got four little pieces of paper in this hat, and I have written down on one of them, it says winner, okay? So let's do it this way. Randomly, give me a number between 1 and 10, please. 3, holy crap. Well, you're going first because that's exactly the number I was thinking. Go ahead. Go ahead, open it up. Look at it. Ah, nothing. All right. I'm just going to move right down the line.
Oh,
here.
Now you smile and laugh. Great. Okay, thanks.
Thanks. Nothing.
Ooh,
all right. There's all a 50-50 chance here. 50. Oh, hold on.
I'll throw that back 50, in there. There we 50, go.
50-50 chance.
Good here luck. Here we go. And this one is?
The winner.
Winner. All right.
Jerry, thank you for playing along.
Thank you so much.
Give them a round of applause as they make their way back to their seats. Wow.
That's awesome. Great job.
Fantastic. Lee Bad. Holy moly. All right, now, we have tried to entertain you with some jokes, and hopefully, did you guys still enjoy that, yeah? Good, good.
Cool. We didn't. Glad you did.
It was pretty brutal for us up here. I'm glad you guys had fun.
But it's time to bring on our featured comic of the night.
That's right, yes, our featured comedian, ladies and gentlemen, you might have seen him on 999, Burn Notice, tons of comedy clubs, television shows. He is hilarious. You're going to absolutely love him. Please give a big, big round of applause to our comedian for the evening, Mr. Dean Napolitano.
All right. Thank you. All right. Happy holidays, everybody. How about a hand for Mike and Eric? I was taking a nap from that last segment of my... Holy crap. Those girls were good, man. They stood up good. That's good. All right. I'm feeling pretty good. I didn't, honestly, I gotta be honest with you guys. I've done comedy out here for my entire career, about 30 years. I didn't think I was gonna be invited back because about 5 weeks ago, after my show, I go into this convenience store, I get a soda, pretended I was deaf. I walk out, but he's like, 219. I was like, all right, whatever. Next thing you know, I'm getting pulled over on Highway 27. They're tasing me. I'm eating a square turkey at Thanksgiving. But I appreciate you having me back, Sheriff. Where are you at? I don't know where he's at. He's still here anyway. I'm feeling pretty good. I'm 53 years old. Anybody else 50 and over? All right. We're the 20 and overs. Wow. A whole 10 of you made it in, huh? Wow. It's like the movie Cocoon here. They're just sucking the life out of the young people, huh? All right. I am single. Anybody else single? That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Married? Clap your hands, you're married. That's some happy married people. You married, sir? No? Boy, you look like you've killed before, sir. You got the hat on, you're like, I'll kill somebody right now. That was me for that $2.19 soda. I'm really pissed off. Can't worry about it, you know what I mean? I'm divorced. Anybody else divorced? It's like 15 people. 50% of America's divorced, but not in Winter Haven. We stick it out, pal. We stick it out. I live with my 93-year-old Italian father. Anybody in that kind of situation? I'm single. I live with my dad at 53. Tough job. I'm what they call a caregiver. Anybody ever done caregiving? All right, 5 people actually care about their parents. Good for you. No, most people don't do it because it's a very hard job. It's an unsung job. It's hard because you've never loved someone so much and wanted to strangle someone so many times. It's true. I've never watched Dateline so many times in my life to get new ideas. You know what I mean? These are jokes. That's why I'm a big fan of the Silver Alert program in Florida. You guys familiar with that program? Someone goes missing, they put up a silver alert. Did you know they find 100% of those seniors when they go missing? And I think that's fantastic because as a caregiver, sometimes I need a break, you know what I mean? I come home from a hard day, I throw my dad the keys, I go, Pop, get us a pizza, see you Friday. Really, I can go? Yeah, sure. I'm kidding, I love my father, but he's crazy. He's 100% Italian. If you don't know 100% Italians, they're nuts. I'm only half Italian. It makes me half crazy. This guy's nuts. And I don't know about you guys, but it's nice to be at a Christmas party, a holiday party, right? You got your faces out, smiles. It's good to be back to normal. Am I right there? Yeah. I think, I've never been a political comic, but I think we can all agree, if you're on the right, the left, the middle, if you see an individual alone in a car with a mask on, you get to knock him right off the highway, am I right? Just Mario Kart that bastard. Just get him off the highway. And we're, you know, 3 years later, we've learned a little bit. We know a little more. We can talk about it and laugh about it because I think in the beginning, in 2020 of March, when the Trump and the Fauci came out and they said, hey, America, we need 15 days to stop the spread. We all said, yeah, we can do it. And we stayed home like good Americans, am I right? But then they came out on day 16, they said, we need another 15 days. And we all looked at our family members and said, you're gonna die, bitch, I can't take it. Because you were never locked in a house with these people for that kind of time. You love your family, but that's day 17, you're gonna choke a bitch, am I right? And I don't know about you guys, I drank every day of the pandemic. I was hammered, I had a beard, swam in a pool. My daughter, I was locked in with a 90-year-old Italian father at the time and my 26-year-old millennial daughter with anxiety. Yeah. Yeah, talk about, oh, and anxiety's a real thing. Don't make fun of it. It's a real, people that have it, it's hard, man. And she's had it since she's a kid, right? They would watch the news, I was swimming, getting drunk. I'd come in, my pop's got he's like, did you see what's going on? You see what's going on? I got so frustrated one day, I tried to smother him with a My Pillow. I was like, come on, get out of my head. He was laughing. He's like, I can breathe, dipshit. It's a My Pillow. It molds to your face. That's the whole pitch. I even got the mice slippers to sneak up on him. I was like, I got you, you bastard. My daughter was raised, she's a germ freak, millennial germ freak, you know what I mean? Ever since she was a kid, every germ's gonna get her, you know what I mean? So she was freaking out about the surface contact issue, you know what I mean? Where you gonna, how you gonna get it if you touch things? Came in from the pool, she goes, Dad, I don't know what to do. I just saw on the news that if we go to the food store and I touch a banana and a guy that just had COVID touched that banana, I'm going to get COVID? Yeah, I laughed too. I was like, Erica, I grew up in the 70s. I ate gum off the driveway. You're going to be fine. I bobbed for apples and other kids spit and snot at the height of flu season to get a dirty quarter that was in my dad's pocket the night before. You know what I mean? But I understood. I didn't blame anybody because we didn't know. First pandemic since 1918. That's how everybody became a historian. 1918, I'm like, all right, relax. I watched the History Channel too. I got you. And they would only let us go to one place. This is where they tested all their theories on us. You remember where that was? The food store. That's where we could go legally. So we all went every other day to get the hell out of the house. And I shop at Publix. You guys shop at Publix? That's like 20 people. What do we got, Winn-Dixie trash in here tonight? Have you been to Winn-Dixie? There's always blood on the floor in the meat section. What the hell's going on in that store? There's always one guy. I shop at Aldi. I like to bring my own box when I shop because I'm a freaking idiot. I'm going to save the planet with a cardboard box. Good luck with that plan, pal. Thank you, sir. Appreciate that. But anyway, wherever you shop, we all saw the safety precautions put in place at the same time. We were lab rats and a live experiment. That's what I think we're realizing now. Because the first safety precaution, when they didn't know, we all walked into the food store, we all looked on the ground, and we saw huge arrows on every aisle. Remember the first time you saw that? We all had the same reaction. What the hell is this shit? And then the guy came over the loudspeaker. Public shoppers, thank you for shopping at Publix. Please notice the new one-way shopping arrows on every aisle for your safety and convenience. And remember, we're all in this together. Remember that? Yeah, we're shopping is a pleasure. I was like, tell the guy with all the toilet paper we're in it together. What am I going to wipe my ass with, Bob? And I did. I followed the arrows religiously because I was raised Catholic. If I don't, I go to hell. That's the rule. And I get allergies. I let out a little cough. I went, my daughter goes, Dad, keep it together. Remember in the beginning if you coughed? Oh, my God. If you sneezed, it was like you threw a grenade down the produce aisle. You remember that? People lost it. They were like, this guy's right out of Wuhan. He's right out of Wuhan. I go, Bob, it's me, your neighbor. Screw you, Dean. I never liked you. Neighbors were freaking out on you, right? I followed the arrows, man. I don't know about you guys. Every time I got to an aisle that I needed an item, the arrow was the wrong way. Anybody else? Mathematically, every time I get to an aisle, I'm like, shit. No one's in the aisle. I needed pickles 5 feet down, right? I'm like, damn it. My daughter goes, Dad, no one's in the aisle. Grab the pickles. I said, Erica, it's a pandemic. Fauci said walk around. We're walking around. And I walked around for that first month like everybody else did. But then at a month in, anybody else do this? You start walking backward down the wrong way of that arrow grabbing you? If you saw somebody coming, you stopped and looked up. Oh, those are olives. We need pickles. Those are olives. And it's funny because when the rules came out, they were one at a time, real quick. They did the arrows first, then the mask. They were going back and forth, right? I never fought the mask because the workers wore the mask. I said, I'll wear the mask for the workers. I didn't, but I noticed people couldn't do both. You remember me? If they followed the arrows, they wouldn't wear the mask. If they wore the mask, wouldn't follow the arrows. It was the weirdest thing. They're like, I'll wear the mask, but this one-way shopping crap's got to end. Then they didn't know the distance. This is all fact, I'm telling you. You can look it up. First it was 4 feet, went to 12 feet, settled at 6 feet. Because people were fighting in the food stores. So they had to put a foot percentage in, right? And we all found out what it was because we went to go check out with our mask and arrows.
You got to the register with this blue tape at every aisle. Remember that? I thought there was a marathon. I go, what the hell is going on? Is there a race? I saw the sign, right? 6 feet, CDC. I'm like, okay, Eric, I got you. We got our mass arrows. We're going to make it. 1918. We got it, kid. You're safe. I made the mistake of stepping up too quick on a guy. Did you ever do that? He freaked out. He's like, hey, back up. I go, holy crap. Because he had on a visor with another mask, goggles, gloves. I said, but dude, was there a radioactive leak in the frozen food section? What the hell happened? He goes, you got to back up. The CDC, 6 feet. I said, okay, I'm sorry. I thought you were moving. He goes, you need to pay attention. I go, okay. He wouldn't stop yelling at me. I'm with my daughter. I'm like, I got to say something. I go, hey, listen, man. I looked in his cart. Right? I saw two cases of Coke, a package of Klondike bars, and two bags of Doritos. Yeah, I laughed. I go, COVID's not your problem, buddy. Diabetes is going to get you way before this does. But I was very nice during it. You know what I mean? I was like good to everybody. I didn't care what side I was. But then here's when we all realized they didn't know what the hell was going on. When we all said, well, man, this doesn't make sense. We got to the food store, mass arrows, blue tape, right? We're doing our job as Americans. On this day, you go up to pay for your groceries, and you notice they're still there. In front of the register girl was a newly installed 6x6 foot piece of plexiglass. Do you remember the first time you saw that? We all had to, I thought I was at SeaWorld. I go, what's going on back there? She had a mask on yelling through the glass. Did you find everything you needed today? What? Did you find everything you needed today? Do I support the gays? Yeah, sure, of course I do. No, did you find everything? I was like, oh, yeah, I found everything. I took two steps to my right to pay for the groceries, and I noticed the bag boy is wide open. You remember that? Protect the cashier, kill the bag boy. We all had the same reaction. This doesn't make sense. The bag boy was clueless. How you doing, sir? That virus is something else. Is plastic okay? Is plastic okay? He doesn't even, I looked at my daughter. I go, the bag boy's got no glass. He's going to die. He's going to die. Cough it up. Monkeypox for everybody. Go ahead. Cough it up. I laugh because here's the thing. We all know when you go to the grocery store, the bag boy is never a boy, right? It's always a 97-year-old guy named Walter, right? He's got a World War II veteran hat on. His mask is around his ear. He's like, you want paper or plastic, Nancy boy? What do you want? You want me to carry it out to your car for you too, sissy boy? I was like, oh, I got my daughter, Walter. You're damn right you got your daughter. Act like a man. I was there, 1918, dipshit. He was smoking a Marlboro at the register. He doesn't want to go home to Sheila he's been married to for 78 years. I'm not going home to that bitch. She's a nightmare. That's how it is in Deltona where I live. You guys seem a little classier out here. Yeah, it's wild, man. Funny thing is, we're getting back to our stuff, you know. They tried to cancel Halloween. Florida didn't fall for it again. We're like, nah. It's because they're already wearing masks. Make up your mind. You know what I mean? What are we doing? I was more upset they called it trick or treat. They said the kids can't trick or treat. You know, you can't, don't call it trick or treat. You can't trick a kid in 2021, 2022. You trick a kid today, they go home crying. The mom calls the cops. Cops come to your house. Now you got an ankle bracelet. You're on a list. You're the weirdo on the block. Remember when we were kids? People scared the crap out of you when you went trick-or-treating. They'd come out with real chainsaws. You crap your pants in the driveway. I just crapped my pants. That was awesome. You'd see your buddy on the way home. You got to go to that house. I crap my pants. I'll be back. I got to change. It was insane, man. We would trick-or-treat in the 60s, 70s, and 80s. You trick-or-treated all day. You got your candy for the year. You remember that? You did shifts, a morning shift, afternoon shift, a night shift. You worked hard, like a pregnant Denny's waitress with eight kids at home. You had to make the money. That'll hit some of you on the way home, don't worry. And we did. We would go out. We used pillowcases, no fancy candy bags, pillowcases. In case it rained, right? If it rained, then you had a weapon for the perverts. You're like, come on, come on. We went out in packs of kids. No one got kidnapped. Remember that? Packs of kids. We weren't worried. Now these kids, you ever watch them trick-or-treat? They do 25 houses and quit. And their parents drive them from driveway to driveway. Have you seen this shit? And they get out of the car with a cell phone on their belt in case something dangerous happens on the way up the driveway. We would go for blocks, man. If we heard, you remember this? If you heard someone was giving out a full-size Three Musketeer bar 27 miles away, you made the journey. Right? From kid to kid, you go, how far? 27 miles? We're burning daylight. Let's go. Sometimes on that journey, true story, 1978, Long Island, New York. I'm 9 years old, right? I get to, yeah, Long Islander out there? All right, just me and you, honey, that's it. I go trick-or-treating, Selden, New York, right? I go, I'm 9 years old, my brother's 16, takes me trick-or-treating. I go to this house. Sometimes you would get a candy bag dropped in your candy bag. Remember that? The little white bag with a pumpkin on it tied up. Had a lot of stuff tucked in it, but you didn't know what was in it till you got home. I got one of those bags, man. I was like, oh my God, I got one. I get home after 9 hours of trick-or-treating, right? My dad grabbed my pillowcase, right? He checked all the Milky Ways and Reese's Cups for poison and razor blades. That one's all right, buddy. You can have the rest. You can have the rest. I go, Dad, you want to check the candy corn? No, the candy corn's fine. Go ahead, eat the candy corn. Remember that? Back then, the candy corn wasn't in a packet. The guy took a handful and just threw it in your bag. Yes. You would look in the corner of your pillowcase. You pull it out. There's hair and you put it on your teeth. I'm a vampire. Look at me. I'm a vampire. Yeah, you don't know why your teeth are rotting out of your head 2 years later, right? I didn't care. He was eating all the good candy. I just knew I wanted to see what was in that bag. I'm nine, right? I was excited. Swear to God, I open up this bag. Inside the bag was a wooden match, a cigarette, and a tampon. The guy played a trick. I was nine. I was like, what is this? My brother's 16, cracking up. I'm like, what the hell is this? Every kid in my neighborhood in Selden, Long Island got a wooden match, a cigarette, and a tampon in that bag, and every parent laughed their ass off at that joke. If that was today, back me up. They triangulate every cell phone to that guy's house. Am I right? Fox News would be there, CNN, FBI. You'd watch the 11 o'clock news. Selden psycho getting kids hooked on nicotine and cotton. More at 11. Not 1978, no one said a word. I'm just looking at it like, what the hell? My brother didn't miss a beat. He goes, no big deal, buddy. Smoke the tampon, shove the cigarette in your ass. That's how it works. Yeah, you're laughing. My ass is up to a pack a day. You know, hard day. How you doing, bud? Halloween, 78, terrible habit. That really happened. I don't really smoke cigarettes out of my butt, but... But, you know, we're here. You know, it's nice. Holidays are here now. Thanksgiving. Would you guys have a good Thanksgiving? Anybody get the square turkey at the prison? That intrigued me. I want to know more about that. Anybody watch the parade this year? See, like 5-6 people. Used to be everyone watched the parade every year because it was fun to watch. The balloons were 1,000 feet in the air. Something dangerous could happen. Now, because one woman was knocked out by a 50-foot Cat in a Hat parade balloon, put her into a coma for 30 days, she sued New York and Macy's for $350 million. You know that? She got the money last year, $350 million. So they had to change all the rules. I'm no scientist, but if you don't see a 50-foot cat coming at your ass, you deserve to die, don't you? You know 100,000 New Yorkers saw that coming a mile away. They were like, shut up, it's going to hit her. Happy Thanksgiving, Dino. Happy Thanksgiving. It's insane. People are like, you shouldn't make fun of Dr. Seuss. He's an American treasure. I don't like Dr. Seuss. Because when my kids were little, I had to read that to my kids. They're like, read to your kids, the teachers, right? It makes you dumber. You're reading the same thing every night. And Dr. Seuss is some tricky dialogue to get through after a six-pack. Let me tell you. You look at the titles, red fish, blue fish, where the hell are you fishing, Doc? There's mercury in those fish. They guilt us as parents today, man. Like I said, I'm divorced, you know, so it was hard when I was divorced because, I got divorced 9 years in. Here's what I did, all right? I was married 9 years. I got divorced. 3 years later, I went back with my ex-wife. Wow is right. Yeah, that was like breaking out of prison 3 years later going, I wonder what the guys are doing. Maybe I'll go back to prison for awkward sex and bad food. That was a good time. It's just, if you're married, stay married. It's not fun being, especially after 50, it's tough, man, being single. I don't like it, you know? I dated a girl for a month. She was crazy and dumb. Sometimes when you're dating, you'll get a crazy or dumb. Every so often, you get the combo meal. You know what I mean? This girl was so crazy and dumb, she tried to kill herself in her garage with her Tesla running. You believe that? She died of thirst 4 days later. I'm so thirsty. A couple of you guys are looking around as a blonde. Well, I don't get it. And they always say you get lonely at the holidays when you're dating. Y'all married? You married? Yeah, it's nice. You look like a good married couple. You got the Griswold sweater on. She's got the gingerbread man. Good for you. Good for you. How long have you been married? 11 years. Good answer. Fast. If you got that wrong, there's no sex tonight, so smart move. Marriage is, stick it out, man. You don't want to be in this game. My parents would have been married 64 years before my mom passed. Yeah. Yeah, I'm glad you didn't clap. No, don't, because in the end, she wanted to stab him with a steak knife every day, I swear to God. He would come out of the bedroom in the morning, she'd look back at him and go, oh, shit, you made it. My mother tried to kill my father at Outback Steakhouse. You believe that? The year she passed. She did. My mother controlled the money. She was an accountant. My dad had a budget every time he went out for a meal. So we went to Outback, I swear to God, we went out to Outback Steakhouse. My sister's down from New York. My mom's fresh out of the hospital. My son's 17 at the time, sitting next to me. Now, my dad's got hearing aids, you know what I mean? Hearing aids work great, by the way, but you have to charge your hearing aids because his hearing aids are always screaming for power, you know? I'm like, pop, eep, pop, eep. Yeah, thank you, sir. And he's just there to eat, you know what I mean? And he knows he can only get certain things with the budget he's on, right? So he gets the Outback Special. I don't know if you know what that is. It's a sirloin and two sides. Not a great meal. Not a horrible, but not great. He gets the meal, right? The waiter drops it. He's like, ah, 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 he's just shoveling it in, you know? I'm not paying attention to this savage. I'm listening to my mom's experience at the hospital, right? All of a sudden, my son starts hitting me. I go, what's up, man? He goes, Dad, I think Pop is choking. You ever been in that situation when you're with someone, you don't know if they're choking, right? So you ask them questions because you don't want to just jump up and start humping your dad at the Outback. So I look at him, I go, Pop, are you all right? He looks at me, he goes. I go, are you okay? He goes. Here's my mother. My son goes, Dad, he's turning purple. Now he's in stage two of choking. He looks like a pelican trying to get a fish down. He's like, agak, 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 agak. It's my mom. Finally, he sees we're not helping him, right? He grabs his water, and he just washes the meat down like a great white, just pushes the meat down his gullet. He takes a deep breath. He goes, whoo. That was close. My mother goes, that's what you get for not chewing your food, you savage. I was like, oh, who? I didn't know this woman. I was like, this is a different woman. My father looks at her, he gets up, and he just storms out of the Outback. Walks to the car, I chase him down. I think he's upset, he almost just died. I get out there, I say, Papa, you all right? He looks at me, he goes, it's your damn mother. I can't chew that sirloin with these false teeth. I wanted the filet for $5. That bitch tried to kill me. So get the filet. You earned it after 10 years. You know what I mean? Thank you guys very much. Enjoy the rest of your party. Thank you.
Give it up, everybody, for Dean Napolitano.
Oh, come on. You can do better than that. How about one more time for Dean?
Come on, Dean. Napolitano, you guys can find him everywhere. He's actually going to be at Laugh Out Lounge in January even. So
shameless plug.
I'm just letting you know.
By the way, where is that located, Mike?
It's literally right over there, everybody. Right around the corner.
Let's take a moment here and thank some folks that have helped make tonight possible. They are our sponsors. We want to thank the Westbury Audio and the tech crew. They're the ones that have made everything look so pretty.
Thank you.
Thank you so very much. This is more for Mike and I, but thank you very much for everything you've done. Also, the Ritz Theater. If you would, one more time for the Ritz Theater. They have been so kind and so generous. Low Payment Kings. What up, Low Payment Kings? Tunes and Tint, Robert Ben's Roofing, Mannix Pools and Grills, Somewhere Sports Bar, International Market World, Ling's Buffet, Willerford Flooring, Teriyaki Madness, all part of tonight's big brouhaha and showdown. It is time for the Ugly Sweater Contest.
Ugly Sweater Contest, here we go!
Ugly sweater, ugly Christmas sweater.
Oh, yeah.
Ugly sweater.
Step over here with us.
Now, just like when you were in high school, just like we do at work, just like they do probably at church, we have been secretly judging you all night long.
That's right.
And we have the names of the six contestants that will be joining us on stage. When your name is called, you come on up and join us, and you will get behind a number. Are you ready? First off, we are looking for Darla Watts.
You can go ahead and cue that music there, Johnny. Go ahead. Johnny Watts, come on up.
Come on, Darla. We're looking for Raul Gonzalez of Winter Haven.
Come right over here to number one.
Tammy and Al Hillman of Winter Haven. Pat Esposito.
Where's Pat at?
Cecilia Coronado.
Yeah, go ahead and give them a big round of applause as they make their way down, for sure.
And I think this is Walter Luce and Bing Worry. Is that right? Of Polk City. Polk City. Yeah, come on in. Join us here. By the way, just want to remind you that we do have a designated driver program available. So
that's
if
right.
You had just a little bit too much to drink, we do and can and will get you a designated driver on the way home. We'll get you an Uber. All you got to do is contact one of our staff, and we'd be more than happy to take care of you. And we also want to tell you that we do have our judges that will be watching tonight.
Are they one contestant? And then
from what I understand, that's the way it was written.
Okay, all right. So you guys are number six over there.
Yes. Yeah, you're number six, number five, number four. Excellent. Excellent. Let me slide over here real quick. All right.
Are we going to start on this side of number one?
Yeah, I got to get through like official stuff here real quick.
Sorry. Go ahead.
Our judges, the Low Payment Kings, also Tunes and Tint, Robert Ben's Roofing, and Mannix Pools will all be judging tonight.
That's right.
First prize, $500 in cold hard cash. Second prize, $250. And third prize will be $100. So we're going to go to the top three. All right. So at this time, I think we could interview real quick.
Yeah, sure. Okay, what's your name for everybody?
Darla Watts.
Darla Watts, everybody, is contestant number one. Darla, if you would please step out there and give us your best sachet and show off your ugly sweater for everybody. Yep. Give us some more music up there please. Yeah, bring that up.
I love the fact that we are on the sweater. That's it. What is it?
Oh, look at the back.
Bring on the Magic or Max. Bring on the Max. Oh, that's clever.
Look at the back. There you go. 98.3
there. Turn it around, darling. Turn it around, baby.
Wow.
Walk that runway, Darla.
That's wonderful. Thanks, Darla. Excellent.
All right, contestant number two, what's your name, sir?
Raul.
All
right, come on.
All right, Raul, go right ahead. Show off a little bit. Let's see it. Come on, let's give it to the judges.
Show that stage presence, Raul. Come on. Yeah, there you go.
Yes, yeah, so make it work, honey. There you go.
All right, sure.
All right, Not bad, Raul.
That's good.
And your name again?
Astatelia.
All right, go ahead and go out there. Show them your stuff.
Woo, I like that.
Come on, give her a round of applause, everybody. Come on.
Come on now.
Make some noise.
We got some work going on. All right, sir.
I think this is going to be the wild side, though.
Yes, it is. It is.
What's your name?
Pat.
Everybody, this is Pat. Come on out and show us what you got.
All right, Pat. Show off that evergreen,
wow.
Pat.
Yeah, the tree. Yeah.
Wow.
That's a Douglas fir if I've ever seen one.
All right. And you guys are?
Tammy Hillman
and Al. Tammy and Al Hillman,
Tammy
everybody.
Tammy and Al, go right ahead. Oh, boy.
Wow.
A little bit risque.
Wow. That's amazing.
I wonder why Tammy. Oh, never mind. I can't say that.
And you are?
Bing.
And you are?
Walter.
Bing and Walter, everybody, if you would, please. Come on out.
All right.
All right. Come on down. Let's hear it for him. Come on.
Well, there you go. That's
it. Edibles are a wonderful thing.
Excellent. All right. Now, the judges are taking a look. They are deciding, and they will be voting on who is going to win.
Who do you think is going to take it home, Dean?
Yeah, give us your expert opinion.
I mean, they're all really good, really, really great. I mean, this is a tad disturbing, but it's nice to look you in the eye. The couples are tough to beat because they did an ensemble. They thought it out, but, I mean, everybody's really got a shot here. I wouldn't lean over in a canoe. You're going to catch 70 trout with that thing. But yeah, I don't know. Kind of like number one over there.
Number one's nice. She's got an advantage.
This is growing on me. This is growing on me.
I wonder what's under the Christmas tree.
Hey.
A stump.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you very much.
I think it's anybody's game. Anybody's
All
game.
Right.
Anybody's game here.
We still are waiting for the judges when they get that done. Once again, first prize, $500 in cash. Second prize will be $250, and third prize will be $100.
Wow.
Coming out. And please, for Mike and I, have you had a good time tonight?
Awesome.
Excellent. Would you mind if we did it again next year? Would you mind? All right, that's cool. That's great.
Holy moly. Now, what was the inspiration for the llama Feliz Navidad here?
I just thought it was ugly.
I just thought it was ugly.
Well,
I
it's
thought
a,
it was ugly.
It's a fa-la-la-la llama.
Oh, wow.
Get it?
You spruced it up with your own stuff. I like that.
I got a question for, is it Al? Is that an organic carrot?
Well, you have to ask my wife. She's in the program, and she forced me to wear it. So.
All right, so we know who's in charge in that household. Good luck this year.
Oh, awesome.
Smart man.
That's right. All right, judges, anytime, please.
Yeah, come on, bring them down. Where did the pink flamingo ugly sweaters come from?
Because I like pink flamingos.
Did you find them, or did you make that?
Both.
A little bit of both? You spruced it up. You found it and spruced it up? It looked fabulous. Very nice, very nice.
That's awesome. That's great. Oh, goodness gracious.
What is exactly that you have over here? Is it Pat? Are you Pat? Wait, which one was... What's your name again?
Raul,
what is this that you have here?
Well, we ran out of room on the Christmas tree, so my wife decided to decorate me instead.
Wow. All right, then. She did a great job.
He's got to go home and put that back on the tree in 30 minutes.
Yeah, exactly.
Still waiting.
All right, still waiting on the judges to come down.
How much have you had to drink, judges? I mean, this shouldn't be that difficult.
Just give us your number one, two, and three pick. Oh, yeah, that's a good idea. Audience vote.
Yeah, audience vote. Audience vote.
Who loves number one? Make some noise. How about number two over here? Number three, the Fa La 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 Llama. That was a pretty good one. The guy with a stump under his Christmas tree. The woman whose breath smells like carrots. Or the pink flamingos. How about that one?
That was a good one. I like that.
Thank you.
Yeah. Holy cow. So, should we talk about current events or something, or what?
I'm reminiscent of the joke off right now. Dean, do another 10 minutes if you would.
Yeah. All right, so.
So my pop, he was dying in Outback.
Good clean joke.
All right, well, do we have these coming up sometime soon? Can somebody give us, we're dying up here. Do we have them?
Did the judges leave?
Yeah.
Come on.
They were old. They had to get beat the traffic home.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, here we go. All right. We got him. Eric, I'll let you do the honors. Right,
here we go. Okay, good enough. Woo, doggy. All right. Here we go. Coming in third place for $100 in cash is number five.
Hey, all right.
Nice.
Second prize, $250 in cold hard cash. Let's give it up for number one, Darla.
Hey, all right.
And the grand prize, $500 in cold hard cash. And the winner of the 2022 Ugly Sweater Contest is number two.
Hey, wow. Sleeper.
All right, give them all a big round of applause as they make their way back to their seats. Thank you guys so much for coming up here.
All right, excellent. All right. Thank you, Dean.
Hey, Dean Napolitano's getting out of here, everybody. Give him another round of applause, please.
I'll be at the Comedy Club on January 15th, I believe it is, that weekend, or somewhere around there. It's in January. I'll see you there.
And now.
And now, ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for the grand prize!
Here we go. Money talk.
Here comes the money.
Now, if you're qualified for the grand prize, we need you to make your way up here. Our three contestants. Come on up.
We need our winner of the Desperate Measure. The winner of
Wrap It Up.
And the winner of the Joke Off. Please, come on down.
Which was a joke on us.
Yeah, no kidding.
Come on up. Excellent.
Choose a box, any box.
Choose a box, any box. You pick the box, any box you want. Don't touch the box. No touching the boxes.
No touching the boxes. Do not touch the boxes.
Okay. And now where's our last one? Last contestant.
There they are, right here.
Here we are. Let's go. Come on. Let's go. Chop, chop. We got things to do.
All right.
The early bird special's nearly done. I got to get there. All right. What's going to happen is... Well, let me ask you real quick. Are y'all satisfied with the box that you have? Are you no touching the boxes, please.
Can't touch the box, please.
Are you satisfied with the box that you have? It's a yes or no.
Yeah.
Hi, we're doing a show over here. Can you pay attention? Thank you so much.
Are you guys happy with the box?
You're happy with the box? You are. Everybody's happy. Well, guess what? Too bad. Now, who's been a longtime listener of the show? Make some noise, longtime listener of the show. Excellent. We have a gentleman that calls in every once in a while. He has been, I mean, a diehard Max Minion. He comes to every single event that we do. We love him to death, and we always kind of make, you know, poke a little fun at him lovingly. His name is Larry. Actually, we call him on the air Larry the Blind Guy because... he's blind, exactly. But he still calls us. He makes horrible bad jokes. He makes Igor sound like a genius with his jokes. He is awesome. We love the guy. He is here tonight. Mike, are you with him?
I'm with Larry. Larry, how you doing? Say hello to everybody.
Hi, everybody.
There he is. Make some noise for Larry. Now, Larry, go ahead, Mike.
Everything was so great.
Thank you. What was the most visually fantastic part?
You guys look good.
Thanks, Larry.
What we're going to have Larry do now is we're going to have Larry scramble them. He is going to tell us where they need to go and just randomly put them in a new box. So, Larry, we have contestants behind box number one, number two, and number three.
Okay, Eric, can you give us a name?
A name?
Yeah.
Sure. So, box number one, you are?
Cindy.
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 She was the winner of the bad joke contest.
All right, going from my left to right, we'll start with number one being the green box on the left.
Okay.
Number two is the red box.
Oh, we're going that way. Okay, yeah, yeah. All right, I got
and then,
you. All right.
That way, from the audience's perspective. So
I got
we'll go one, two, okay. three.
One, two, three. One,
now,
two,
Cindy
three.
Right now is at number three, Larry.
Number three.
Would
sure.
you like her to move?
No.
Great, Larry.
Great. Thanks for playing along.
Did you get the memo on how to do this, Larry?
Yeah. Larry, we want you to move her. Where would you like her to move to? One or two?
One.
One. All right. She's moving to one. There
she's
we go.
She's moving to number one. You guys come down, and you will go behind number three. Excellent. Now, box number two, you guys are who?
Rosalind and Wade.
Rosalind and Wade?
Rosalind and Wade. All right. Rosalind and Wade are currently at number two. Where would you like them to move? One or three?
Three.
Going to number three. That's right. Where they're going.
Over here. Number three. Excellent. And you're going to number two. And you guys are?
Connie and Alan.
Connie and Alan. They are at number two.
They're currently at number two. Would you like them to go to one or three?
One.
One it is. There we go.
All right.
They're back to their original box.
Oh, over here. This way. There we go.
All right. Larry, we're going to do this for the next 20 minutes. Where would you like Cindy? I'm just kidding. No. I think we're good. Does that work?
So.
Everybody happy?
Are you happy? Cool.
Awesome. Right. Larry, thank you so much for your help. Say goodbye to everybody.
Goodbye, everybody.
Thank you, Larry. Appreciate it. All right, Mike, make your way back up here real quick, and we will do it to it. Now, in these boxes are balloons. There is a present balloon. There is a snow globe balloon, and there is a Santa balloon. The Santa balloon is worth $1,000 in cash. All right.
The other two have to pick up our bar tab after the show.
Right, which is about $1,000 in cash. So what we will do is we will give you the instructions. You're going to reach in, grab it. They will open up like a book, and you will let the balloon fly, and we'll see what happens.
All right.
Do not touch until we
don't
tell you to
yet.
Touch.
Don't do it yet. Don't you? Yeah. We need a. Are you ready?
I am.
We need a drum roll, please. We should actually have a drum roll. There it is.
There we go. All right, audience.
All right.
On the count of three, we want you to help us. On the count of three, you're going to open your boxes. Here we go. One,
two,
three.
Go. Open them up.
For Connie.
$1,000, Connie.
And we do have some great consolation prizes for you folks for coming up and playing as well, but we really appreciate it. Congratulations, guys. Way
there
to go.
There you go.
Thank you so much.
Head right on back to your seats, everybody. One more time, give them a round of applause, please, and thank you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that is going to wrap it up.
That's it. We're done. Thank you guys so much for coming out here tonight. Please, another round of applause for all of our sponsors. Everybody at Ritz.
Yes.
1916 Irish Pub. All of our sponsors. The Low Payment Kings.
Thank you very much.
Have a great night, everybody.
Please drive carefully, and we'll talk to you on the radio in the morning. Good night, everybody. Keep ringing. We're rolling. Do we have speed? Do we have sound?
Speed, yep.
Okay.
Speed and sound. Here we go.
Here we go.
Historical. I love it.
And I will tell for the record, we will never have one of those in winter.
I've had gout flare-ups that are more entertaining than this.
I don't have gout.
What's that bank gout, guys?
I quit. I should have been on CNN.
Hardworking, dedicated.
They're hardworking, they're dedicated, blah, blah.
Oh, they are.
Yeah.
Okay.
Don't be nervous.
One more time.
We'll try it again and give a pause between the two.
Okay. That's cute, Mayor Danza. Where is Winter Evan?
Open the door and come out.
Oh, okay.
I'm just saying F them?
Yeah. Go.
F them. I thought you were going to say go on. I thought you were going to drop me in there. You're still here? It's over. Go home. Go.